Hello everyone, this is Justin, bringing you another coffee chatter. You see, I got my iced coffee with me, and today I'm talking to a good friend of mine. His name is Greg. Say hello, Greg.
Hey, how's it going?
His name is Greg Coachman. Wonderful last name because he is a personal trainer, not a coach man, but maybe it would be better fit if his last name was personal trainer man. Right?
Yeah, right.
So, just to ask Greg, how are you on this lovely day in Philadelphia? What are your plans for the day?
Taking care of business, going to work, training some clients, enjoying the weather. You know, it's sunny out today.
Please sound more enthusiastic because most of the people just went to sleep. Come on.
Enjoying the weather.
Did you not get enough coffee?
No, I'm actually on my
okay, there you go.
First cup today.
All right.
I had a late start, but yeah, going to work, training some clients, enjoying some weather. Try to get out of the gym a little early so I can probably get outside to one of the beer gardens in the city.
Beer gardens?
Yeah.
On a Tuesday. Are you an alcoholic?
On a Tuesday. No, I'm not.
Oh my
but
God.
But I do enjoy craft beer, you know. I don't overindulge, but I do indulge. But.
How wonderful. Fantastic. Awesome. All right, well, here's another question. You're a personal trainer at the same gym I work at the moment. How long have you been a personal trainer, and tell us what your plans are in the future as a personal trainer?
I've been a trainer for 5 years, for a year and 2 months at the club I'm at now. And my future goals for being a personal trainer, in all honesty, I want to own my own club.
Own club. Big dreams, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I do work in real estate as well. I own
Works in real estate, oh my God.
Yes, so I look at it from the entrepreneurial standpoint. A lot of gym owners actually never been trainers. There are a few, but a lot of them are just businessmen. So I feel like I can take my business mind and my fitness mind, put it together, you know, and try to get some type of commercial space, some kind of warehouse space, and put that together and have my own club.
The helicopter is louder than Greg right now, and that helicopter is miles away.
I'm sorry.
You can speak a little louder. All right, that's awesome. Was there anything you wanted to do before becoming a personal trainer growing up?
Yeah, well, real estate's been my dream since I was 16. I had an uncle who dealt in real estate. He did really well in real estate. But I also had a dream to go to the Olympics for boxing at one point in my life. That was when I was in my teens, early 20s. I had that dream. I didn't have a lot of commitment to the disciplinary end of it. So that was totally crushed.
So he's fucking lazy. Let me settle for whatever I can do that will allow me to be lazy.
Whatever it is you do, you gotta love it enough to put everything aside that you like. So if you love something enough, the things you like that may not have the same, that don't just synergize with your goal, then if you can't leave those things alone, it's not your dream, it's not really what you want to do. So that, I think, in my mind, it couldn't have been that much of a dream of mine if I wasn't able to put other things to the side, like my dealings with women. You know, sometimes you gotta go to practice, you gotta work hard, and playing around with your girlfriends, you know, you gotta put that things to the side, you know. So things like that, you gotta put to the side. You want to go have fun with your friends instead of going to the gym in the morning, doing, you know, working out at 5 a.m. and then going back to the gym after school at 4:00, stuff like that. You got to be committed to. If you're not willing to do that, then that must not really be your dream. Because one thing I did hear about LeBron James, was one of the best basketball players to live. He worked out before school, played basketball after school. So these are things that you have to have a commitment. Now real estate.
I have to stop you. I was starting to cry right there. I'm actually crying internally. From all the things you just said, it was so beautiful. I need a moment. I'm a little verklempt. I'm getting emotional. All the tears are coming up the tear ducts. It might be too beautiful. But go on. You were talking about real estate, making the segue towards real estate.
Well, I lost a lot of money doing it in the beginning, And I gained some money, so I take the good with the bad with that. So ultimately, that is my dream, because I took the good, the bad, whatever came with it, and I continue to go along with it. Now, you know, things are getting better, but I accept everything that comes with that. So that's genuinely my dream. That's my goal in life. And with fitness, I've always been in the gym. Since being a teenager, always been in the gym. I love being in the gym, and I love to help people when they're willing to work. So when I get somebody who's willing to work, that's those moments I'm like, all right, this is what I do this for.
I'm over here listening to that, crying like a bitch. But I just stopped. Yeah, I was off camera. I was sobbing. The waterworks were coming down. That's amazing, Greg. Amazing as usual. Tell me what kind of training you usually like to do. A lot. I know CrossFit's a big thing these days. I know that there's a lot of people who like to do mostly interval training, Olympic lifting training. What is something that you like to do the most?
Everything you just named, all of them are great. I'm not opposed to CrossFit. A lot of people, they are opposed to it unless they do it. No, I'm not opposed to it. Those guys are turning everyday average people into athletes. Like, I love their concept and the way they work. And as long as you're in a good coach and you're in a safe environment doing CrossFit, I have nothing against it. Now, certain moves from CrossFit I'll use, but I don't do CrossFit. Olympic style lifting, I'll teach a client that later on down the line, but in the beginning it's all circuit training, you know, weightlifting, getting their cardio together. The Olympic lifts and, you know, the compound moves, those come later once you figure out how to work out properly. So all the above are great. The intervals, I do that as well. TRX is something I also do, so I try to switch it up depending on who the client is, what I'll use.
You mentioned TRX, and that also is fun. Here's a thing. If anyone doesn't know what TRX is, it's basically just like ropes that you use body weight off of. And it's actually something that if you go at a playground, you could actually use the swing set instead of a TRX, which is, I think, is awesome. You should do...
No.
Play... what?
No, it's not.
I think so. I think he's crazy. It's like, I like doing playground workouts, and I like to use the swings for... the TRX ish workouts.
Yeah, right, whatever.
What an asshole. All right, well, that's wonderful. I'd have to ask, are you naturally bald, or is this is something that you always shave, or is it because you shave it because you're noticed that you're LeBron jaming a little bit?
I noticed it, and one thing I'm not scared to do is make a choice, and instead of holding on to it, I made a decision. And I got rid of it.
So it's not a thing that only black guys can do. If I do that, I just look like a cancer patient. But you do it, you look great. But you know what? I like it matches.
Hey, Jason Statham.
And Jason Statham. Outside of Jason Statham and black guys, we can't do it. But I do like the beard. The beard matches the bald head. It's a nice combo. It's a better combo than the Frontier rifle and the shorty. He doesn't know The Last of Us. Here's a good question. Do you ever play video games? And if you play video games, are there any that you like?
I'll go buy a video game in the past, play it for like one day, and then get so frustrated with it that I'll never pick it up again. So
he sounds like he played Battletoads.
I used to buy them and then play, couldn't end it. I'll call a friend who was good at it, like, hey, come in this game so I can see what it looks like. So,
you know, here's a good thing though. If you play a video game or watch, if you're like that kind of person that likes to watch people play video games, you gotta have your friend over, have them play a video game. You guys, you know, drink beer and enjoy the gaming experience together, right?
Yeah, I guess.
I was just trying to make that a positive. Is there any video games you remember playing that you're like, okay, I like this?
Oh. I love to go to like certain, like we have Barcade in Brooklyn.
Ooh, Barcade? No, it was Barcade in Brooklyn?
There's one in Philadelphia. Now, I like those old school games that I grew up off, like the Ninja Turtles and the NBA All-Star Challenge. I like to drink my craft beer and get busy on the video games.
Now, for those who don't know, Barcade is a trendy bar Apparently in Brooklyn. I didn't know it was in Brooklyn, but it's in Philadelphia as well. And the one I've been to in Philadelphia, it has all these retro arcades.
Same concept. I think it's probably the same company.
So you can drink all these delicious craft beers while hanging out with friends, dressing nice, trendy, while playing these...
You don't really have to dress nice.
People there dress nice, though. You don't have to. But you go there, you can play some old school retro arcade games and try to pick up a chick, right? Because there's some good looking chicks there. So Barcade. If you don't know what Barcade is, look it up, find out. It's a great place. Great place to hang out.
Yeah, definitely.
And you don't have to be a gamer to go there.
No, not at all.
You could be a casual like this buffoon. No. Well, that's nice. Yeah, all right. The one thing I also noticed about Greg, and I told this to Greg the first time I met him. What are these tight ass pants? Yeah. Look at this, they're suffocating. What is wrong with you? What are those?
You gotta evolve with time and your fashion as well as your outlook on life. Everything's gotta evolve. Who knows?
You're the only person evolving.
Who knows? Next month I might wake up in the morning and say, hey, I want to look like a character of Pirates of the Caribbean. If I feel like that day, that's what makes me happy. Go ahead.
You will get some interesting looks, to say the least.
The point is, however you're feeling that day, go with it. Just go with it. That's my point.
That is some beautiful words. And last thing I want to mention is that you have this, when you personally train, you have this motto. This phrase that you use, please tell us what it is and what it means.
Are you trying to get right?
What does get right mean?
Like, are you trying to get your body right? Are you trying to get your mind right? Did you come in here to work, or did you come in here just to give me your money and have me sit and listen to your problems or you complain? You trying to get right or what?
So basically, if I go to Greg as a client, I ask, Greg, how do I get toned up? How do I work out my my arms or my chest? The answer?
You trying to get right?
I'm trying to get right. Oh, okay. What do I have to do to get right? Get right. Okay, but what? Listen, you either get right or you don't get right. Get right.
Well, the first step to getting right is getting that check right.
Give me the money, please. Oh my God. Well, that's wonderful. I want to thank Greg for coming out on this beautiful day and summer day in Philadelphia.
Thank you.
I want to thank you all guys for watching. This is Greg Coachman from Philadelphia, a great personal trainer. And take care, guys. Thanks for watching.